Hi, welcome to Radio 1 Movies with me, Rihanna. Out this week, we have The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 2, The Dressmaker, starring Kate Winslet, and The Perfect Guy. We're going to start with The Hunger Games. Finally, the rebellion that's been talked about for a while happens. The districts try and invade the capital, and Katniss becomes obsessed with taking down President Snow.
I'm going to kill Snow. Nothing good is safe while he's alive. And I can't make another speech about it.
Now you're talking.
This is what happened when I spoke to Woody Harrelson, who plays Haymitch Abernathy, and Julianne Moore, who plays Alma Coyne, the president.
What do you think it is about The Hunger Games that has captured everybody's imaginations?
Well, it's a remarkable story about trying to find your moral center, you know, in a turbulent world and learning whether or not you have free will. And here's this young woman who feels like she's just acting on her instincts and instead finds out that her instincts are true, you know, that she really does have a very honed sense of right and wrong. In the process of speaking her mind, she actually incites a revolution and changes her world.
Well, I think it's incredibly entertaining. I think Francis is really a master filmmaker, and I think that he's made these, you know, movies that are not just entertaining, but also really about something really important.
We all have one enemy, and that's President Snow.
This finale really does come as a relief, and I think what the Hunger Games franchise has always done really well is surprise us with their unexpected plots, and this is no different.
He turns the best of us against each other.
We see a return to the more Hunger Games-esque peril as our heroes have to dodge these horrific traps set by the games makers, which makes it so much more exciting and tragic, which was notably missing from the last film. The last third is perhaps a little bit anticlimactic, but ultimately satisfying. So 4 stars for The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 2. Next up is The Dressmaker. Tilly, an incredible dressmaker, comes back to her tiny Australian hometown and her mad mother in search of the truth about whether she murdered a boy when she was at school, and ends up uncovering a whole lot more, including Liam Hemsworth's body.
She tells them that they're all different, even though they're all the same. Too fat, too skinny. You'll be a sight for sore eyes. Anyway, lo and behold, our genius here does make them look different, less like themselves and more like they want to be, don't you?
You just called me Tilly.
When?
Just then.
Oh, I never.
Yes, you did. And this morning, twice.
Oh, liar.
Sounds like this is the most important piece of clothing I'll ever own.
It's an odd film because there is something incredibly romantic and sweeping about it, especially when Liam Hemsworth is looking hungrily into Kate Winslet's eyes. But it also descends into a farce with these comical townsfolk trying to chase her out of town in a really theatrical kind of way. And I think when you skim the surface, there is something really tragic and thought-provoking there, but it's almost lost in this mishmash of genres. So 3 stars for The Dressmaker. Finally, it's The Perfect Guy. Leah breaks up with her boyfriend, but finds another one pretty quickly who seems almost too good to be true.
Hey, would you mind terribly if I took a picture of this car? See, I've been wanting to restore one just like it.
I'm sure that's fine. Maybe ask my boyfriend.
This starts off as a fairly standard romance, but then things get very sinister and dark very quickly. And actually, I think it's quite a realistic representation of what someone would do if they were being stalked. It doesn't get too hysterical, which is to its credit. I thought the lead woman was really well written, but the boyfriend with the psychotic tendencies just descended into cliches without any real explanation, so that was a bit frustrating. 3 stars for The Perfect Guy. Next week, it's all about the Oscar contenders, so I'll be reviewing Carol, Bridge of Spies, Black Mass, and thank goodness for Disney making it all a little bit lighter with their film The Good Dinosaur. I'll see you then.